Sound glitch is adding static. There we go. Sword explodes, permanently lost. The aqua spirit is a mermaid. Oh shit. Oh no, dude, it's Orgotamir. This also kind of reminds me of Mega Man Legends. That's the final dungeon in the game. I actually need to go through it no less than 4 times in order to get everything. That seems to be implying that she leaves the team to make room for Melvin. But thank Christ. Thank Christ. You can just go and swap Marable for any other character. No, I actually didn't want to leave. So now that I have the final key, there's some chests that should be available to me. I've been wondering what a... Oh, not this one. Where is it? Where's the door? I've been wondering what's in these chests since literally the beginning of the game. They either can't be opened at all or you need the final key to open them. Yeah, they can't be opened at all. They're literally like pretend chests. These chests, on the other hand, are very real. Alright, so I now have access to the whole world again. Alright, prepare. Platinum shield. 30 defense, don't care. I don't think Platinum Shield is going to be that good for... Oh, it is good. Good for Ira. I prepare. The King Sword. This is actually stronger than the Aquagon. But the Aqua... Oh, it's actually slightly weaker than the Aquagon. Okay, the Metal King is stronger than the Aquagon, and then the Oceano is the strongest sword. I guess I'm going to give this to Ira. Ara, ara. I want to go visit Graykos. I need to swap Marable. There's like several things I need to go visit. In the ocean. Huh? I learned D-Magic? Huh? I'm becoming matured. I'm rank 5 hero. What the hell? When did that happen? I guess I've been hero for a while. I've been hero since before Gabba was a god hand. Bitch, join my squad. I can't imagine a universe where someone left Gabba. Alright, I guess I'm gonna warp to this town that I'm literally in, just to move my boat. Endgame, boys. Launch us to our glorious watery graves. Hello, Undersea King. Not really. You rescued me when I jumped into the sea after being jilted by my lover. Japan loves suicide. It's very romantic in Japanese culture to throw yourself into the ocean. I had to go northeast until I hit Krakos. I don't quite know where this is. Pirates attacked with cover fire? I did not remember that was a thing that happened. If you're in this boat that they assist you in fights, I like don't think I've ever seen that. Attacked with cover fire? What the fuck? Okay, I think it's more south and more east. Go visit Krakos. If you have not fought him by disc 2, he cannot be fought. I already beat him up though. He gives you the shard for free in disc 2. You don't have to fight him or anything. Hi. Huh? Can't be opened. There we go. Demon Spear. This is quite a powerful weapon, and I think it's not cursed despite having demon in the name. It's pretty strong for Maribel. It might be the strongest weapon Maribel ever gets, besides the ultimate whip. Let me double check to in fact confirm that it is not cursed. There's a bow gun, I forgot about that. I don't even know where to get it. May instantly kill a targeted monster, attack power plus 99. Well, that's all I need to hear. Not cursed. Damn it. Alright, now I want to go visit the Metal King, because I've got lots and lots of tiny metals to offload. Metal King Shield. Bolero. That makes it so all of your spells cost half MP. Makes it pretty good armor. This is a damn good shield and everyone can equip it. Hero hasn't had a new shield in the longest time. I'm still using the goddamn Dolphin Shield. Which is still better than the Platinum Shield that Ira has. Alright, now I'm gonna teleport to Falrod. Because I've got 2 question mark shards to pick up. Or
It's all stolen, Luigi.
I like to think of these two shards as the two most forgettable things in the entire game. I haven't won all the contests yet, I do kind of want to do that. Shit, partying. I think. Maybe we can go to the pool. Fishy guys down here. Question mark shard. Very, very missable. It's like you'll find him usually on your first pass, as long as you don't forget about him. Then you're gonna get that shard. But it's very easy to forget about him. Long way. Confuse Pang. Heal us. I guess at some point I'll probably turn on that cheat just to max all my jobs. It's in the past in this area. Aw, shit, I just remembered where the warp is. It's not on the ground, is it? It's in the Sky Fane. How do I get to the Sky Fane? Do I just use the Bliss Rock to get to the Sky Fane? Oh, you can teleport to the Sky Fane, that's right. Doink. Oh fuck. I did it. This game has one of the hardest post games to see of any video game, if only because it's so long and involved to even get through it. Not that I'm at the post game yet. You do have to beat the game in order to get the post-game unlocked. Weebs are a disease. Why'd I have to go so far for this shit, dude? You can't get this on your first pass. You have to come back and disc. Who would ever come back here in disc 2? I hate these enemies. Fuck. Okay. Immediately blinds my entire team and creates the sound glitch. Should be right down here. Fuck. Petra fish. High crit, right? If you actually came back down here, and you actually talked to these two NPCs again, you get a fucking question mark shard. How in the holy mother of hell are you ever supposed to even notice those two characters, let alone think to come back here after beating the game? Alright. I guess I can put in some of those question mark shards just to show off. Then I maybe want to hit the final dungeon once or twice. You have to go through it 5 times, actually, to get everything. Oh, he just reminded me of that time. I missed a platinum sword because I didn't do that. Return to the ruin, I suppose. So here's a pedestal I never completed. It's kind of small. I have 2 pieces for it. And then here's another door to another pedestal I never completed. This one's a bit tongue-in-cheek. You can already tell what I'm going to be making. I have a pretty good number of the question mark pedestals, or question mark shards. Alright, now where? I actually want to go back to Hamelia, because I never did that hat side quest. I like usually don't do it. Can I not do anything about that? I don't know what it is that triggers the hat side quest. I might have already missed it since it's disc 2. I doubt it, but I might have. These enemies are kind of tough. I've never played Super Robot Wars. Robot Wars. Whatever, I'll do this later. You don't even have to do those side quests. Where do I go now? Whatever, let's go do the final dungeon first attempt. Dungeon is all around pretty spectacular. Very appropriate final dungeon. Really long and really hard. Rainhawks. Another classic enemy. Another fucking ultra high level enemy at that. They have a lot of health too. I forget what spell it is that Rainhawks are known for. It might be Mega Magic. In the monster games, anyway. Firebolt. They're definitely very magical. Excuse me. I've never really been that invested in Gundam. I don't really like, giant robot shit. Or it's not that I don't like it, I just don't care about it at all. This is a very big dungeon, there are a lot of wrong ways to go. I think that might be the Larmir. I don't even know why they added this into this game. The Larmir is like a standard in Dragon Quest games, but it really has no place in this one. It's just sort of abruptly thrown into the end. Ira literally knows no spells. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. I've gone through here a lot, so I'm pretty sure I can just do it purely from muscle memory. Whoa, that's a poisonous field. The real question is, can I find all the chests in my process of going down through here? Mimic for sure. Tiny metal. I've needed to go to a shop for a long time. Demon Lord's Throne, perhaps. That's treasure. Another tiny metal. How does the game know I need these so badly? I need like 6 more to get the question mark shard. Necrowall. Oh no, dude. Okay. No, it still sucks. What the fuck am I talking about? Maribel, my character on my team with the highest speed, fucking got such a low speed roll there that I couldn't heal myself before the fight ended. That was gay. Oh, baby. We're getting deep. One of these is good to get pulled into, but I can never remember which. Might be that one. Might be this one. These things like grab you and pull you in. Or was this one? Bleh. World leaf. Give me a tiny metal, you skeleton. There's, I think, a thief skill called Tiptoe that lets you, ignore fights. This is a guaranteed. Whoa, it's a metal, yes! Pretty please! Yes! 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 That damage. Do your thing, little devils. Do it, do it, do it. Come on. Cool. This damn creature, unfortunately, has a lot of health. Aw, oh, damn it. Well, I killed one. I like magma. Is there anything in here? No. I didn't know Metal ES could be encountered here, dude. That's a great enemy to run into. Druin Lord, Blood Beast. Zombie Cut probably does lots of bonus damage to these guys. I've never used Multicut. Holy Sword Fury. There's so many goddamn pages of skills. There are so many ways to play this game and get different skills, but unfortunately the basic gameplay of this game means you're going to be getting the same ones every time. There's not enough varied ways to play make your character. All I needed was some way to get the monster jobs really easily. Again, Maribel with the low speed roll. Kind of annoying. Giga Draco. These are a famous enemy from the series. Enemy encounter, but it's always one enemy when you have one of those eggies. Of course, it's the last one. There. I don't think there's anything else if you destroy all these eggs. I hope not. Metal, yes. And it did its call for help with business. Sword Dance does nothing against them. Just got a Metal Cut and pray. It'd be nice if Marable got the instant kill. Damn. The crit! Yes! Ooh, all that experience! I just got 2 levels on my main character. Oh, we're gonna be here a while. Metal Kings are pretty great to farm. What would really absolutely destroy me is if it dropped an item. Oh my Christ, the odds of that are so low. I just got the Luck Shoes, dude! That's one of the rarest items in the whole game. That might be the rarest item in the whole game. Walk to gain experience. I put that shit on and try it out. Every step you take gives you EXP. Holy fuck, was that a good encounter. I think there's a any metal in here. There we go. You don't even need to walk through like an enemy infested area. It's like 1 EXP per step, so it's very slow. Oh, fuck. Okay. Damn it. Geared Rickos. That fucking crit! Before he could make a decision. Oh, insta-kill. Demon Spear nailed the vital spot. That happens sometimes with Demon Spear. It's a pretty good weapon. I think it has the highest rate with the dagger. The dagger is actually a bad weapon, while the demon spear is actually a good weapon. You could just fucking, Blueprint. I didn't need that. I don't know if you can level up outside of battle. I'm pretty sure you can. I think it just keeps on grinding EXP for you until you get to, like, 1 EXP to level up. And then it just automatically, like, it just stays there until you fight. I think it's Hero that has an inherent that they heal HP after every turn. Like, obviously I'm recovering HP after every turn because I'm wearing the Miracle Armor or whatever it's called. Sacred Armor. But if you are a hero after, I think, job level 7, you'll automatically recover HP every turn. Kind of cool. Makes it dramatically easier to, you don't have to, like, heal all the time. I think it is this one. followed by this one. I'm almost. Yeah, I'm to the split. Here we go. I'm gonna do the water one first, because it's arguably the most useful. Aqua Charm. There are four different ways to go in this area. Oh shit, my mom never called me about the Bugman. I gotta check my email really fast. Not my email, my text messages. Oh shit, no! No! My mom asked him to show up at today, Wednesday, fucking 12 to 2. I didn't answer my door at any point from 12 to 2. Damn it, dude. He probably showed up and then left. Oh, I'm gonna have to apologize to my mom. I wasted a bunch of time for everyone. Motherfucker. That, like, completely slipped my mind. Oh no, it healed itself. This water-themed region. The water one has the coolest items. How could Dragon Quest VIII be the best one ever made when I'm playing the best one ever made and it's not 8? Shit, dude. Enemies pull no punches in this area. Marble needs more HP. This is 7. Disguiser. Oh shit, is this the one? This might be that enemy. One of the enemies in the final dungeon can take the form of your party members. And you have to use the alarm mirror to turn him back. I don't think it's... I don't remember if it's this one. Transform. Oh shit, it's me! Oh shit, it's Marable! Kind of weird. You don't see those sprites most of the time. You can use the alarm mirror to change them back. They have access to like all your spells when they transformed into you, which is kind of terrifying. This is not the remake. The remake isn't even out yet. Question mark shard. Fun fact! That's a fucking question mark shard. There's a post-game shard here. Oh shit, I wanted to use the lava one. Zero one isn't as good. Ira? She's pretty hot. That brutal hit. I think she copies your stats too. Thank you. Question mark shard. There's the portal to the Demon Lord, who I'm not going to fight because I can go behind the waterfall. Behind the waterfall is a kind of cool looking chest. Inside that chest is the strongest sword in the game, the Oshino Sword. It's kind of good, and unlike the Aquagon Sword, it can actually be equipped by every character. I have a lot of fluff in my deck, don't I? My items. Ira can equip it and it's really good. My Protag can equip it and it's really good. Technically speaking, more useful for Ira. I'm gonna keep the King Sword, it's cool. So that's what I was here for. Now I'm going to cast outside. I guess I'm going to go straight back in. So I've got to do that like 4 times. But now it's going to be a lot faster because I know my way through. And I'm not trying to look for chests. It would be even faster still if I tried to ignore fights. The Oshino Sword has some pretty cool little side effects to it that make it really good. Like when you swing it as a weapon in battle, it has a secondary effect that like casts water magic on the enemy. And I think you can use it as an item in battle to cast Tsunami. It's like one of the best weapons in the game. It's probably the second best. It's kind of neat to get it. Rainhawks, dude. God damn it, I failed to kill either of them. My health is shooting up so goddamn quickly with my Protag. All my characters are getting a lot of health really fast. Probably because all those level ups they got from that one Metal King. Luck Shoes, dude! Luck Shoes are like the equivalent of catching a Chansey. Oh shit, it's Petragon. It's a Dracorps. That's not even what a Petragon is, Petragon's a different thing. Dracorps is a pretty cool name. Rainhawk is pretty muscular, dude. How do I get Rainhawk physique? I want to be swole like a Rainhawk. I mean, I kind of want to do these fights to get level ups and shit. But also, I can just cast Tiptoe if I wanted to. And I'll still get fights, but just way slower. Tiptoe costs 0 MP, and it just has the effect of a repellent. It's a pretty broken spell. It's only learnable by thieves, which is a class that it's easy to not ever make. It eventually wears off, confusingly. But you can recast it, and again, there's like no downside. It Cost 0 MP. Tiptoe is no longer effective. I think that's the door to enter the castle, but you don't actually need to open it at any point. Or rather, I don't even know if you can open it. I'm pretty sure you can't. It'd be really easy to just get deep in here if you could open that door, but I don't think it's possible. When will I play Valkyrie Profile? God, the notion of getting this deep in this place like 4 times kind of sounds like a pain in my ass. I'm like inside Mentorok right now. A literal eye on the wall just turned into a literal mouth on the wall, and also the entire room is alive. Tell me that's not Mentorok. Mentorok is fuck. Alright, it's going much faster this time. This is the last room before the spirit rooms. What's Valkyrie Profile about? Is it like a tactics game? I think I heard someone call it a tactics game once. Or is it like a JRPG? That was really quick. Alright, so I did the water one. I did the Terra one. I did the two that I'm not equipping. Different things happen depending on which one you use, which is why they lead to different places. No, I want to keep my tiptoe up. Oh yeah, you can destroy walls in this one. It's kind of cool. There's nothing really indicating a wall can be destroyed, you just have to kind of bump into them. And hope the one you touch is destructible. I thought you still encountered enemies when tiptoeing. I can't seem to. There we go. Some kind of super bomb crag, some kind of super well. River rock and well ghost. Well ghost. I can only presume the river rocks know farewell, or like some reviving skill. Since those enemies are kind of gimmicked around the idea that they can explode and die, I would say it's quite likely that they know the spell that brings people back to life that involves them exploding and dying. Is this really a dead end? I need those. I was transitioning screens too fast to get fights. And now I'm not. Come on. I guess it could have been this game, but I doubt it. Or not this game, but this series. But those enemies didn't become like a thing until kind of later Dragon Quest, like 4 or 5. So, like, it must be somewhere else. Gaela. Gaela. That's the ultimate armor. It's pretty good. By pretty good, I mean it's fucking incredible. Literally only my Protag can equip it. A tiny metal. The only shard in this area is, in the water one, though. Oh, so that thing's still alive. Imagine if I was using normal attacks, how long every fight would take. God, 1,000 experience points for a normal fight. Not even 800. And I got 33,000 for killing that Metal King. I kind of figured that there would be a staircase around here. I forget. Let me find it for you really fast. There's not much to fucking, like, explain, though. I don't know if I really talk about, like, how to install it and shit. Someone on my Dragon Quest upload. Oh, shit. I just clicked a button. Someone on my Dragon Quest upload literally just posted, stop spamming us with this non-Street Fighter shit. I like joke about people saying that, but that's the first time anyone's actually said it. I can't imagine anything I would want rather than the Gaela armor and the tiny metal. But I just really thought that there would be like a staircase or fucking something back here. I don't know where to go. It's gotta be up there. It's the only place that makes sense. You gotta do like a huge lap around the whole thing. I like don't even think it's unwarranted. I am putting a bunch of shit in people's sub boxes that like they don't care about. But I'm uploading these in the smallest in the biggest pieces that I can. I can't upload anything from Twitch longer than 2 hours. Shit, I didn't want it to be hustle. Wasn't paying attention. And there are people kind of invested in this run. namely me, but a few others. Alright, that looks like that. I got the armor that I needed. That's the way to the Demon Lord. Failed to kill even one. I could lose several characters here if I'm unlucky. I was not unlucky. Oh no, I'm unlucky. This looks really bad, but they're all nearly dead, so it's kind of okay. Looks like there's nothing in here. Finding the proper ROMs is literally never a pain. I have no idea why so many people have such a hard time finding ROMs. I've literally never heard of an instance where you can't just Google it. It's like insanely easy. The only thing I can think of is some people like get the wrong ROM, that like not the one that Fightcade asks for. This is not Breath of Fire, this is Dragon Quest. It's Dragon Quest 7. But even if you get the wrong ROM, like you can just like if you go into Fightcade, it'll tell you the ROMs you need and their little like number things, their identification codes. And if you search the codes, you'll find them in like 2 seconds. It's like not very hard at all to find the right ROM. I don't know why, like, this idea that it's hard is so prevalent. Oh, no, I'm bothering to grind this. There's a random chance that a person will show up in this map. God, the entire notion of trying to get people of the right, like, thing I'm looking for. It could be that my chance is like zero, because the very first time I stepped in there was a person, and I missed him, because I didn't look. In fact, I consider that quite likely at this point. MD5 sums, yes. That. I've never had it not be correct. If you like search for the right sum. It's like the last enemy I just found. Things have so much goddamn health. Thordain. It still tells you every single one you need. As a Warpriest, these are extremely rare enemies, and their heart is like the most valuable heart in the game. This is the best monster job in my opinion. And arguably the best job. Let me actually read aloud what the Warpriest's skills are. Prepare yourself. Hang on to your butts. Warpriest. Strength no change, agility no change, guard plus 10%, int plus 30%, appearance plus 10%, max HP minus 10%, max MP plus 30%. Learns magic back, revive, firebolt, defeat max, exploit A, blizzard, blaze most, multi-cut. I guess that's not super crazy, it's just that it has a shit ton of MP, which is really nice. MP is like the big question mark at endgame. For a lot of the, for like the super bosses. If you master it, you get a permanent int plus 20. What am I looking at with the human vocations? Damn. I am 90 battles from mastering hero. The last two skills it gets are fucking nuts. I would be lying if I said I'd never fallen into the trap of something that only stupid people fall into. Something you have to be dumb to screw up. You don't have to get all these items. Like, I absolutely don't have to do the last two charm areas. I'm just kind of... There's a good... You might remember right at the beginning of the game. Okay. Remember the first dungeon? I had to find, like, a sword, a shield, a helmet, and a... armor. And then those were associated with the spirits. The aqua one was associated with the sword, and that is the Oshino sword. The sword you get in this final dungeon. This Terra spirit was associated with the armor, which is the Gaela armor, which is the armor you get in this dungeon. The fire one is associated with the helmet, and the wind one is associated with the shield. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It doesn't take that long to get down here, but it hurts that I'm only like most of the way down. It's not like I'm really grinding anything right now. I've got at least two tiny metals to take to the Metal Man. Which means I only need at most... I only need like 15 more if I'm gonna go crazy. And, not 50... Yeah, 15 more if I'm gonna go crazy. And 5 more if I just want 100%. I've never gotten the 110 tiny metal prize. I've got the 105 one before. The 110 one is just insane, though. 100 prize is a question mark shard. 105 prize is a Plat King heart, which lets you turn into the Plat King job, which is probably the best or second best job in the game. And the 110 prize is the ultimate whip, which is the strongest weapon in the game. Not only is it the strongest weapon in the game, but it's a whip. Oh shit, dude. things are suddenly very, very, very ugly. But Fael has like too much health that he could ever die. That's still really annoying. Having revive is kind of nice. Alright, let's hit up the fire one, I guess. I don't know the way through these areas, to be honest. I like don't know these maps at all. I think there is a certain point when you're trying to do something, especially if that something is, like, illegal, that you should... Ooh, white fire! That's the upgraded Scorching. That hurts. A lot. It has to fall back on you to be able to figure out how to do it. You know what I mean? It's like if you can't help yourself, no one can after a point. I probably should have cast just two Helas. Helas heals about 100. That'd have been fine. The one thing I don't want to do is go straight to the end. And yet I feel like that's what I just did. Burning Bridge. Motherfucker, I did go straight to the end. These enemies are far more dangerous than I give them credit for. White fire, dude. How'd I fail to kill either one? I got like round about the same damage on both of them. Oh shit. It hurts. Almost no treasure in this region. Damn, these are like rainhawks, but on fire. Hellhawks. When I have like some kind of big spell I can just cast, it'll just fuck them up. That did a lot of damage. I'm gonna die. Despite its name, Pentacle only panics one enemy. This is terrifying. Hellflame? Uh-oh. That did a lot. Oh man, don't die, dude. I've got to go all the way down there again. What a bitch! Why were those enemies so hard? That's alright. But shit, that's another pass. I don't want to have to keep going down there forever. Hellflame? I didn't know there was a single enemy that could cast that spell. Hellflame does like 150 damage to every enemy in a group. I absolutely cannot live through that shit. There's like no strat I have. That can handle fucking 600 damage per turn damage output. I'm actually gonna back that question up. And by back that question up, I mean I'm actually gonna like you're saying it with a kappa face, but I actually am saying it seriously. What is the hold the free content produces a free content to any quality standard? Speaking as a guy who produces free content. Well, it's not like I mind criticism. I quite like it. But I've definitely run into a bunch of people who are like, do this my way. It's like, shut up, man. I'm not making this for you. If you don't like it, go somewhere else. Everyone gets so mad when you say that. I don't understand why that makes people so angry. Just find out that fucking their opinion doesn't really, like, affect your plans necessarily. It's like, shit, dude, you'd hate if I told you what to do. I make a lot of considerations for people who, have criticisms. The only ones I really resolutely refuse to change are the ones that are either massively inconvenient, like, add, like, slides for every single video I ever make. Or, things that, like, I do something for a very particular reason and the person just doesn't understand the reason. You know what I hate? All the time I get people recommending me to do things I already do. It's like, Beth, you're fucking... Back when I did the B&B combo videos for Street Fighter 4, it's like, you should have timestamps to all the different sections. And I literally already had timestamps. Or like shit like that. I like when people try and give me advice to make my videos like more popular. Is this really the only chest? And it was like 10 steps away from exactly where I was. Fuego helm. I think it's not even good because I've got Metal King helmets on everyone. Evade some magic. That's probably better, even though I lose some defense. No, it probably isn't, because I'm pretty sure it's the same magic. Alright. We've got to go deep into this area twice more. I've got to get the windshield, and once you go through this area, nothing saves. So I have to save after having getting everything. Like once you kill the last boss, nothing saves. These enemies are quite hard. Do I just not even have the lava stuff anymore? I just sold it or something? Just put it aside. I can cast magma. Magma is the spell. I forgot that I had that. I can cast it for free. I don't need to fucking sometimes have it succeed and sometimes have it fail by using the lava staff. Protag straight up unaffected. It is kind of annoying when people are helpless, isn't it? Second to last trip through Final Dungeon. I'm running out of shit to do in the game. I'm not gonna do anything to try and fully gear up my squad. I have more examples of people recommending me to do shit I already do. I get a decent amount of people saying you should make a video on blank, and it's something I already made a video on. And granted, some of those times recently have been like things I made a video on in Street Fighter 4, and I haven't made it in 5 yet, which is one of the reasons I made like a crouching DP video. But they'll be like, "Hey, you should make a video on autocorrect," and it's like, "Well, actually, oh fuck." I'm pretty sure that How to Be a Subatomic Physicist is actually not on the internet. And if it is, it's certainly not the complete information. Do you play Fightcade much, Sefrik? What kind of old games do you play? If you say Street Fighter 4, I'll clock you through the internet. I don't think I've ever heard you talk about, like, you seem to have played like a bunch of Street Fighters besides, or like fighting games besides Street Fighter 4. But I don't think I've ever heard you talk about what like fucking old video games you like playing. Old fighting games you like playing. Fastest area to go through so far seems to be the oh, you've never even installed it. Those are the games I used to play a lot on Fightcade, plus Vampire Savior. Those are like the only old fighting games I really like. I like Super Turbo, but I much prefer to spectate Super Turbo than to play it. I find it really aggravating to play. Or not really aggravating, I kind of like it, but just like you know. Super Turbo is a game where you have to be very perfect for a long time. It's difficult. It's a difficult game to play. Little mistakes cost you so much, and the execution is quite hard for some of the more advanced shit. Oh, it's one of these. Oh, Magma can just fail. Okay. It's not even the staff, it's just the spell. Guaranteed brutal hit. These enemies aren't so bad. To be honest, I don't quite know where I'm going. I don't seem to be able to get on that pillar. What the hell is that hole? Uh-huh. Is Beth bad at puzzles? Sword Bane. Kind of a cool enemy. I always forget that Ira has the Sage Rock. It literally cannot be a bad thing to pick this up now. Oh, that's the shield. Tornado shield. So I've gotten all four pieces of the spirit gear. Tornado shield is pretty godlike. It's worse than the Metal King shield. So it means it's pretty great for Ira. Not much point for anyone else. This map isn't big, but it's confusing. This should just take me to the exit, I think. Damn it, I didn't want to go out there. Maybe I did. Oh, there it is. Okay, I've fully explored the, well, I guess I'll check this wall. Yeah, okay. I've now fully explored the dungeon of the last boss. Now it's time to, save the game and beat the game. This should be the last time I do the final dungeon, provided I actually win, which I could easily not. Possible the NPCs can't even appear here. I just got one. Farmer. Let's see here. I'm gonna go to the middleman. And then I'm gonna go to Rexwood and save. I should have enough tiny metals to get all but the last three prizes. Question mark shard coming your way. Often absorb MP. Your MP costs are halved. Oh, it's not that good though. Your MP costs are halved and you absorb MP from like spells, I guess? I don't know. You a store. Nah, I can do it. It's just sacred armor. I've got better shit now. No, there's an infinite number of them, dude. I'll keep the miracle sword because that's kind of cool and rare. Fygo helm can't even be sold. I think I already have a backup tray. I never got the bunny suit. Okay, I don't know. I don't want to sell that. I don't know if there are more of those. I can sell the speed rings. King Sword's worth a fortune. It's one of a kind. I used it as a tool. Why am I keeping the C-Roar staff in my inventory? Not that good. Alright, I'm looking pretty good to save the game and go kick some ass. Watch the game's ending and shit. To be 110% honest, I'm not even sure if I can kill the last boss with my current team. I'll give it a go though. The last boss isn't dramatically harder than the last time we fought him. It's just Orgadamir. He has about twice as much HP as the first time. And he's a bit stronger, but not much stronger. So it's just a longer fight. But there are more interruptions because he's one of those bosses. An evolving boss.